Thanks very much. You're all very welcome here this evening. My name is Joe Flaherty, but if you don't know that, I'm in serious trouble. Yeah, but we have a fantastic show here for you tonight. It was a very unusual concept when the guys put it together first, and they probably struggled to convey the message of it, but I've been lucky enough to see bits of it, and it is a really top-class show. And to give you a bit of background to it, it's Craggy Island meets Loch Ree. It's a story that preoccupies most of us here in Leinster anyway. It's a perpetual search for money. So we have obviously Father Ted, Anne Dougal, Mrs. Doyle and the whole lot. And there's great excitement when they find out that Kier Mullooly and a TV crew are coming to the parish, and they decide it's an opportunity to make money and get them away to America. So it's a really good show. Their plan runs aground though when the Bishop Father Mickey Riley finds out, and he's not too happy about it. And he intervenes and he tries to thwart it. So there's highs and lows. It's a fantastic cast. You have your program there, and you can see the names, but it's a real Fain family. It's I was trying to think, Father Ted is Paddy Fain, and I think I first saw Paddy Fain in a play here in 1980. So he's a long time on the stage, and he really hasn't changed an awful lot. And his two sons are also in the play. We have Colm and we have Alan. And of course, Colm is also the author of the play here as well, or the playwright, to give him his full title. And he will obviously get €2,500 this evening for having written the play. There's a fantastic raffle as well. There's great prizes. We got a late sponsor as well, Colm Quinn Motors. He's trying to stifle Mickey Flynn's dominance in the Leinsborough market. So he's given a Mini. So it's a Mini Coupe. It's the first prize in the raffle tonight. And it's a 181 Mini Coupe, and it is a fantastic car, and it's out the back if anybody wants to see it, but it is a fantastic car. So we'll be going around selling the strips of tickets. I won't be selling them because I'm not allowed to handle money, obviously, but there will be people going around selling strips of tickets, and make sure you buy them. And I know Mickey Flynn will be upset at Colm Quinn coming in here, but it's for one night only. As I said, it's a fantastic show, but it wouldn't happen without a few key people. Obviously, our director here is Maura Tobin. She's put a fantastic job into the show, and she worked really hard. And to tell you the truth, there wouldn't be a show without Maura, because they were absolutely going no place till Maura got involved. They were bumbling along, and I'd say it'd be 10 years' time before they'd be ready to put it on. So, like all things, it took a woman to come in and whip them into shape. And I'm delighted to see my two favourite performers, Sarah Finnegan and Carmel Annan, are back on stage again. Poor girls are typecast. Every time I see them on stage, they're nuns. So I don't know what they're doing in their private lives, but definitely the public perception is that they're nuns. So listen, it's a great show, and just one final bit of housekeeping. It's unusual in that it's not in two parts. There's four parts. So that means, because I'm getting €2,000 as well, they broke it down into 500 for each part, so I'll have to come out each time and talk a bit to you. So I think we're about ready to get this show. I think we're ready to rock, and somebody should come to my ear when I say that. We rehearsed this, it was perfect when we rehearsed it. Okay, we have a problem with the show, I'm afraid. We've had three cast members, and they've stage fright, and they're not able to take part in the show. But they're not major parts, so we just need a bit of audience participation. So we just need some people to come and help us out as part of the show. It's not a big job. You'll get €250 each for doing it. Because this is clear. If you saw the props inside, this is high budget stuff, I'm telling you. Sean Moran and the community scheme, they wasted no money in this. Every penny was spent on it. I'd say there'd be no food festival this year because all the money is squandered on this set. So, Liam Connerton, if Liam Connerton's in the audience, can he come up? Liam, you're in the show. Liam was at the early rehearsals, but they said he was too big. So, Liam, if you come over to the side door, you got a part. Can you give Liam a bit of encouragement? Liam, the show can't go ahead without him. We can't start without you. You'll have to come. I know you're bad in the walk, Liam, but you'll have to come.
Come on, up
Come on, Liam. Come on. And Sean Moran, is Sean Moran with us? So Liam and Sean, two of you, can come over to the side door. It's really only a walk-on park. Be no problems, yeah. You'll cut. So we're going to cut the third section out of the show because Sean Moran and Liam Pollard won't come up on the stage. So on that basis, everyone's entitled to a €2.50 refund. And if Martina McGrath is out, she was taking the money on the way in, she'll give everybody €2.50 on the way out. And if you feel any way aggrieved at all, take it out on Liam Connerton and Sean Murray. They destroyed the whole evening. So ladies and gentlemen, what was meant to be a four-act show is now a three-act show. But without further ado, give it up please for Craggy Island meets Lochree.
Right, that's Wednesday's mass sorted, and maybe Thursday. Would you take Friday morning's mass, Jack?
No.
No, too early maybe. How about the evening mass?
No, definitely
I'll have to take that as well. Right, I suppose, how about the Saturday morning mass then, Jack? No, right. I guess I'll take that as well. Doesn't like doing mass. Oh, God.
Morning, then.
Morning, Dougal. Dougal, there's just a bit of shaving foam on you there, Dougal.
Oh, no. You're all right, then. All clear.
Dougal, it's on you, Dougal.
Oh. Gone now, Ted.
Dougal, well, there's a bit here and here. Dougal, it's all over the place.
What? Ah, God, Ted, how did that get there, huh? Ah, Ted, God, I didn't even shave this morning.
God.
So, Ted, what are we at today? Mass, confessions and all that, I suppose.
Yes, Dougal, all that.
God, it's great being a priest, isn't it, Ted? My God, it's lovely out. Monsterfest is coming to Lochree this weekend.
Monsterfest? Ah, Dougal, I wouldn't have much interest in that type of thing now.
They have a monster baby coming.
A monster baby?
Yeah, it's like this freak show thing. You know, it has the body of a monster, but it's actually a baby.
Right, so Dougal, how is it a monster baby? Has it got fire coming out of it or something?
No.
Well, has it got the head of a baby?
No.
Right, well, does it gurgle at you, or I don't know, does it look like a monster? Or is it kept in a pram, or in Lochree, or... Dougal, are you confusing this with a possible dream that you had, or is this actually real? Dougal, have you been studying the diagram like I said?
Oh, God, Ted, yeah, no. Now that I think of it, it was a dream.
Yes.
God, sorry about that one, Ted.
Dougal, if you had three wishes, what would they be?
Oh, God, no, Ted. I'm fine. I wouldn't want anything.
Right, you wouldn't want anything at all?
Oh, God, no, Ted.
Right. So... if you had this cup, Dougal.
Oh, God, yeah. That cup. God, Ted, that'd be great. If I had three wishes, Ted, I'd wish for that cup.
Right. So if you had that cup, you wouldn't want anything else at all?
Oh, God, no, Ted.
Right. So if you had a big car, Dougal?
A big car! Ah, God, Ted, a big car. God, Ted, if I had three wishes, I'd wish for that cup and a big car. Yeah. God, that would be just fantastic, Ted.
Right, Dougal, I see. So that'd be fantastic. A cup and a car, you'd be absolutely delighted.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so you wouldn't want to be a rock star, Dougal?
A rock star? Ah, Ted, come on now, a rock star. Oh, Ted, if I had three wishes, I'd wish for that cup and a big car and to be a rock star. God, yeah, Ted, that'd be great.
Yeah, see, you've never had much of an imagination, have you, Ted Dougal?
Ah, you're right there, Ted. What would your three wishes be, Ted?
Ah, well, Dougal, I suppose I'm already heavily involved in charity locally, so you know I'd like to bring that to a kind of a national or international level, do.
Like the Lord's thing, Ted.
Dougal, that was charity work. Well, it was just a misunderstanding, but don't bring that up again, Dougal. Well, you know, as I said, I'd like to be an activist for charities right across the world. You know, and you know, that Las Vegas thing, none of that would interest me whatsoever anymore. None of it. Yes, but, you know, as I said, none of that Las Vegas thing would interest me whatsoever.
Right, so, Ted, let's see what's on the television, huh? Right, so, Ted, maybe I'll study that diagram, huh?
It might be best, Dougal. Another TV broke. It's four TV. Hello, Father Ted Crilly speaking. Terry, who? Listen, Terry, I have no idea how you got my number, but that money was only resting in my account, Terry.
No, sorry for disturbing your father. I'm Terry McNamee, and I work in film production. At the moment, I'm making a movie called The Passion of St. Tibidabo. Now, I was hoping to do a special on priests who live in isolated areas and included in the movie. Would you possibly be interested in me coming to talk to you about your experiences as a priest? I think it would add some human interest to the movie and work wonders for promotion.
Absolutely, Terry. That sounds extremely exciting. I'd be very much interested.
Great. You're the first person we thought of, Father. We would, of course, be willing to offer you a huge fee for your input.
A fee? Oh, excellent. Excellent, Terry. I'd be very, very interested.
Who's that, Ted?
Hello? Can't really hear you, Ted. Lyme seems to be very bad. Now, I'm going to need some directions. How exactly do I get to Lockree? It doesn't seem to be on any maps or even on bloody Google.
Ah, well, we wouldn't be on any maps now, Terry. We're not exactly New York. No, the easy way of finding us, Terry, now is sailing past Newtown Castle. You'll see a big glow-in-the-dark symbol at the Lanesport Power Station. You're very close to the island then, Terry.
Great. Okay, we're on so far. One last question. Are there any other priests there? Well, your researcher didn't mention that there were any other priests living with you, so I just wanted to check.
No. There's no one else living here now, Terry.
Okay, great stuff, Father. Thanks a million. Talk to you soon. Take care.
Thanks, Terry.
Answer back, Ted.
Dougal, those are not ants. They're real people.
What?
Dougal, have you been using the binoculars on back to front again?
Oh, God, yeah, Ted, you're right. God, look at them. Look at all them people. God, Ted, there must be at least 20,000 people out there, Ted.
20,000? Really, Dougal? Right, yes. Dougal, as I said before, that's up close, but those are far away.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And, Dougal, another thing. Never turn on the TV when Father Jack's asleep. You know how he gets.
Ah, come on now, Ted. He's always asleep, isn't he?
Anyone who has served the Lanesford Church for as long as he has deserves a rest. Look at him there, so peaceful and refreshing looking.
Ted, Look at me, I'm on the television. Hello there, I'm Father Dougal Maguire, and welcome to this week's Top of the Pops. At number 45, it's Father Ted Crilly with I've Got the Power. And at number 15, it's Father Jack Hackett with I'm a Sleepy Priest.
Hello to you all.
Hello, Mrs. Doyle.
Has the television broken again, fathers? Never mind, nothing that can't be sorted with a bit of you know what's in the head department.
Huh?
Now, what's your tea?
Me, Mrs. Doyle.
Tea,
I'm fine, Mrs. Doyle.
You won't have a cold.
No, I'm fine, Mrs. Doyle.
Are you sure now it's hot?
No, Mrs. Doyle.
All right, so. That one would you not drop?
Well, Mrs. Doyle...
I tell you what, Father, I'll pour it for you there anyway. I'm sure you can have it if you want.
God.
Now, and what do you say to a cup, Father?
Fetch your cup.
He loves his cup of tea.
Fetch your tea.
Father, I forgot to mention, a Terry McNamee phoned earlier.
Oh, who's that, Ted?
I've never heard of him.
He mentioned something about the television.
That's right, he's coming to fix the television.
Well, he's going to be here tomorrow around 12.
Great, Mrs. Doyle.
No bother, fathers.
Good thing you called him, Ted, huh? The television's still broken. Simply the best! Dum, dum, dum. Better than all the rest. Dum, dum. Better than anyone.
Doing the old pop star thing there, Dougal.
Damn, Ted, yeah. Good. It was great being on TV there. You know, got the old Teddy bug.
Yes, Dougal. It might be best to go upstairs.
Did you ever want to be on TV yourself, Ted?
No. I wouldn't have much interest in that type of thing now.
No. I don't think you'd be much good at animals, Ted.
What? Why?
You're too serious, you know? And your eyes, they're a bit funny, Ted. They're a bit cross. The camera can pick that up, you know.
I am not cross-eyed, Dougal.
Come on now, Ted. You are a bit. For God, half time. I don't know if you're looking at me or Father Jack.
You might best say some prayers now, Dougal.
God, it's cross-eyed.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed
be thy
name,
Papa, don't preach, ice baby.
You know, Dougal, you can pray to God by playing with Spider-Man.
Really, then? God, that's like that time you told me I could pray to God by just leaving the room.
Ha! Yes, that was a good one as well.
Oh, Ted. One joke.
Yes, Dougal.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Father Noodle Maguire.
Good night, Dougal. Hello, Father Ted Crilly speaking.
Hello, Father Ted. How are you doing? This is Terry back
in the meeting. Oh, so you've made it then, Terry.
Well, I'm on an island, Father, but I'm not sure if I'm on Loch Bree. I can't see any signs or anything. Can you give me any directions?
Well, is there a man with a t-shirt beside you that says, I shot your, beside Casserly Shop at the field?
Funnily enough, there is, Father, yeah. And listen, is that the big field owned by that big landowner, Paddy Fane?
Oh, you've made it then, Terry.
Grand, so. Well, I need some directions, an idea for the location, if I can.
Well, no real landmarks here now, Terry. I suppose the island itself is a kind of landmark.
Grant, the line's breaking down there, Father. I can't really hear you that well.
Oh, sorry, Terry. You caught me at a bad time. I was on the port before and on the toilet. The island itself, Terry, is a kind of landmark. But generally it's said when you're going away from it towards Cashel, you're going in the right direction.
Oh, Grantso. Grantso, I don't care. Can you give me any location? I need anywhere I can look out for.
Hey, yes, yes. I can meet you at my house, off Lockery. Ask Tom there and he'll help you out.
Grantso, thanks, Father.
Thanks, Terry.
Tom, my good man. Is there any chance you'd give me directions for that good man to Father McCready's house, please?
I shot a man.
Oh.
I was in an argument.
Class.
Brother.
Jesus, where?
My old dog did that to me. Doesn't it look like a pig?
Yeah, it does, yeah. Good shot. That's, well,
what's
this?
Four!
What? Wait, maybe you can read the room, Father. Thanks, Will.
Dougal, don't waste the day now and get Father Jack off to the cliffs. And this time, Dougal, make sure you put the brakes on at the cliff edge. He was only just lucky the last time.
Right, so, Ted. Are you coming?
No, I'll most likely stay here and have a pray.
Pray? What are you up to, Ted?
Dougal, I'm not up to anything. It's not unusual, you know, for members of the clergy to have a pray once in a while.
Hackett, are you ready for your walk?
Nothing Father Hackett likes as much as a walk.
Oh, God. Now! Oh. So be careful. All right, Jack! Come on, Jack, do it!
Oh,
God!
Oh, jeez! Right, so, Father McGuire, we'll try again later. You settle yourself and make the tea.
Hello, Paul. Come in, Paul. Would you like any tea, Paul?
No, I'm fine.
Right. Would you like to do one for the day, Paul?
No.
Right. Are you sure you don't want any tea, Paul?
No.
Have you seen Father Mickey Riley lately?
No.
No. I suppose he's about 70 now.
I don't know. Here I come.
Dougal, just relax, Dougal. Dougal.
Ted.
Just relax, Dougal. We have a visitor.
Ted, it's Father. It's
I
Father.
Know, it's Father Stone.
Stone, Ted, it's Father Stone. Oh, my God, Ted, it's Father Stone.
You're going to have to keep me company, Dougal.
No, oh, God, no.
Yes,
no,
Dougal,
no, no, no.
Yes,
no,
Dougal.
No, 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 no.
Paul, you remember Dougal?
Yeah.
Of course you do. You've been coming how many years now here? Six! 6 years exactly. Every summer. So, what time are you going back tomorrow? What? Right, for how long?
3 weeks.
Huh? Right. Great. Yes.
I said, Father, stop!
Do you not have to get back to your parish hall?
No.
No, no, right. Okay. Yeah, because it's just that we have this thing, me and Dougal, yeah, we have this thing that we were going to do, don't we, Dougal?
Yeah, that's right.
What was the thing that we were going to do? You know the thing. You know, there was a thing, holidays, that's right, holidays. Oh, yes, we're going on holidays.
No,
actually, no, there was definitely something else that we were going to do. What was the other thing, Dougal, that we were going to do? You know, it wasn't holidays. Sorry, Paul, I just have to have a chat with Dougal. Oh, God, Dougal. Oh, God, Dougal, we have to get him out of the house, Dougal.
I
can't stand this, Dougal. Maybe you'll take Paul out for a walk.
No, Ted, no. You're not leaving me alone with him. God, no.
Right, would you like to take maybe Jack then for a walk instead?
Right, so, Ted. I'll give him a coat.
Yeah. Good, Dougal. Right. So, Paul, would you like to go for a walk, Paul? Paul? Hello, Paul? Paul? This is probably normal. Dougal, Mrs. Doyle? Well, I think we might have a problem here now.
What's wrong, dear Ted?
Well, Father Stone there, he's not looking too active. I might have to give Dr. Sinnott a call.
Right, so, Ted.
Yes, I think this doesn't look good. I'll give Dr. Sinnott a call. Hello, Dr. Sinnott?
This is Dr. Sinnott's mobile number. Please leave your message after the beep beep.
God. Yes, Dr. Sinnott looks to be out. I'll bring Paul down to the hospital. Maybe Mrs. Doyle, you could bring Father Jack out for a walk.
Right, so, Father.
Dougal, could you maybe mind the house till I'm gone?
Definitely. No problem with that.
Great.
Right, so, Father Hackett, off we go. Come on, we'll go up to the cliffs. I know they're a bit windy now at the minute, but look, it'll be grand. So must get these brakes set out again then as well, Father. They're a bit dodgy at the minute, so hopefully you'll be all right. Man, now, Father, off we go. Whee!
Right, Dougal, I'm going to lift Paul up. I'm going to lift Paul, Dougal.
Good man, Ted.
Give me a hand, Dougal.
Oh, wait, stop, Ted, he's moving.
Dougal, I'm moving him, Dougal. God, Dougal. Just make yourself useful, will you, Dougal?
Good man, Ted. You're doing a great job, Ted. Feck. Arse. Women. Drink.
Father Ted, I'm Terry McNamee. How are you doing? Nice to meet you. We did have the interview today, remember?
All right, yeah.
This is my crew. Come on in, guys. This is Fionn and Fiochtina. And we're going to get set up here and we're going to have a little chat. Take a seat, make yourself comfortable.
Interview?
Absolutely.
Am I going to be on TV?
Yes, you are. Can we get a nice close up on you? Good looking man. We need to get a close up here. Are you comfortable, Father? Yeah?
Yeah.
Great. Okay, we're just going to have a short couple of questions just to kind of get a feel of where you are at the moment, all right? Can I ask you, Father, please, what exactly do peace do here on such a remote island? Okay, that might be a bit difficult. I'll tell you, move on to the next one, Father, but you're doing great. Can you tell me about what your hobbies are, please?
Well, I love rollerblading. And
chewy fruits.
Yeah,
rollerblading and chewy fruits.
That's a good combination. Yeah, yeah, good. Why not? Can you tell me what your favourite festival is in the church calendar?
Monsterfest. Yeah.
What?
Monsterfest. It's great. And it's coming to Lockery this weekend.
Terrific.
Yeah, and have a monster baby coming too.
Lovely.
It has the body of a monster, but it's actually a baby. And it's real.
That's great, yeah. Sounds very good. Well done, yeah. That'd be nice. Can I ask you, what is the busiest time of the year for priests? Is it Christmas or Easter time? What do you think?
Oh God, easy. Christmas. Yeah. How does he do it? You know, the big man. They deliver all them presents to children in one night. God, I don't know. Magic.
Yeah, you might be a little confused, Father, but yeah, I suppose, why not? Yeah. How would you describe the faith since the time of St. Teresa's here on the islands or in the country?
Oh God, this faith stuff and God, it's all mad, isn't it? I don't get it.
Yeah, it's an opinion, I suppose, yeah. Okay, so what's your opinion of women becoming priests? What would you think of that?
Women, priests, oh God, no. How would that work, huh? Imagine, Mrs. Doyle, a priest. God, there'd be no work done. Who'd make the tea?
Yeah, well, I suppose it's as good a reason as any, yeah. Well, listen, should priests be allowed to marry them? What do you think?
Well, we already do.
What?
Oh, yeah. What? We do the whole lot.
This is controversial.
Weddings and baptisms and communions.
Oh, jeez. Oh, yeah.
The whole lot.
Yeah, I suppose, yeah, I forgot. Yeah, fair point. Okay, your last question, Father, okay? Is there much excitement here in Ireland with the impending visit of the Pope this summer?
Pope?
Yeah, Pope.
Coming to Ireland?
Yeah.
When?
This summer.
Ah, God, he kept that one quiet, didn't he? God, I knew he'd come. After the great time he had here on his last visit. Well, that's just fantastic.
That was great. Good you're happy. Well, listen, that's all the questions we have, Father. But listen, we have a small matter of the fee to discuss. I promise that we do something nice and we give you a decent fee, so.
Oh, God, no. I'm fine. I had 3 wishes this morning with Ted, and I'm absolutely fine.
Ah, no. Listen, we have to do something now, Father. But fair is fair. You gave me your time. It's important.
Well, Ted said you were coming to fix the television.
It's in shite, isn't it? Okay, I'll tell you what we can do. We can arrange a new TV for you. A nice flat screen. How does that suit?
Yeah, perfect.
Spot on. Well, listen, Ted, my people will be in touch with your people. We sort that out. Great to talk to you. Thanks for everything.
Right.
Let's wrap this up, guys. Moving on. Good job. Take care.
Dougal!
Well, Ted.
Well, Dougal.
The TV people are here, and they're going to send us out a brand new television.
Great, great.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
And they interviewed me as well, Ted.
Sorry, Dougal. Interview?
Yeah.
Interview you, Dougal!
Yeah.
For the television? Great.
That's right,
yeah. Great. Oh, God! Great.
Who are you looking for then?
Priest.
Who?
Hey.
Ted who?
Priest.
Oh.
Ah, Len, how's it hanging?
That's it.
Oh, your grace.
By my proper title, I'm a bishop, you little prick.
Yes, your grace.
Sit down. Now, this film business.
Film?
Yes, film. This blasphemous film.
Oh, yes.
The Passion of St. Tibullus. I've been called back from my holiday in California to sort this out. They're trying to lure our priests into making it. You two better not be seen involved in this. I'm warning you.
It's a tea for everyone, fathers.
Me, Mrs. Doyle.
Great, Mrs. Doyle.
Now you have
have a cup, Your Grace.
I won't, Mrs. Doyle.
And go on, you'll have a little cup.
I have not got time.
Go on.
No, Mrs. Doyle, I am fine.
You'll be a bit of piggy in the middle now without a cup.
It's best you say yes, Your Grace.
Right, okay, yes. Thank you.
And you'll have some cake, Your Grace.
No, I'm fine, thank you, Mrs. Doyle.
I'll go on, you wait.
I am fine, Mrs. Doyle, thank you.
There's cocaine in it. I mean, what are those things called again? Raisins.
No, I'm fine. I had that by time. Thank you, Mrs. Doyle.
All right, sir.
His Holiness has banned this film, but for some reason or other, it's been shown on this godforsaken dump. What are we going to do? A protest. This is where you come in. A dignified protest outside the cinema. We have to make the church's stand known. Do you understand? Are you listening?
I am then. The lights are on, but there's nobody home.
Critty, this is a very serious matter. Do not fuck this up.
Yes, Your Grace.
Your trolley when you were on out of the way. I saw it in the garden.
Thank you, Mrs. Doyle.
No bother, Your Grace.
I'll be in touch with you later on in the week. Is that clear?
Yes, Your Grace.
Oh, God. We'll definitely go and watch the film, too. We'll bring it out in the morning.
Right, so, Dad.
Could be good.
Careful now.
Down with this sort of thing.
Careful now, Ted.
Dougal, is this the TV crew, film crew that you interviewed with yesterday?
Oh God, Ted, I can't remember. There's just so many different productions of TV and film. You know, it's showbiz lifestyle, it's just hectic.
You know, if Len does find out, Dougal, we're fucked.
We'll be going and watching it after.
Keep us down, Dougal. But yes, it's probably be a good film. We'll definitely get in for free to see it later.
Hello,
Jim.
I seen your pictures in the papers, Father. All about the film project. I think Dougal is in the film too.
Right.
So, is it a blasphemous film, Father?
Oh, it is, Jim.
What sort of thing, Father?
Mad stuff.
It's very immoral, Jim. You wouldn't like it.
Is it a type of nudie thing, Father?
You wouldn't believe the amount of nudity in it.
Is it just the top half?
Well, Jim, you know, nothing is left to the imagination there now.
Right so, Father. That's down.
God. Hello, sisters. Right.
Oh, we saw a great film last week. What's it called again?
Oh, The Crying Game.
That's right. And you wouldn't believe it, Father. One million laughed. It's only Leno.
You see, there was this great scene in it. See, it was all about this girl. Only she wasn't really a girl at all. And then you find out, actually, she's a man. No.
You laughed it out.
Oh, God. Yes, well. Yes.
So I'm very light at now. A few weeks ago. Oh, that's right. You know your man's father. All over everything I have. Cheerio, Father.
Hello, Pat. Pat, how is your wife? I heard she wasn't well.
She's dead, Father.
I'm very sorry. When did she pass?
About 2 hours ago, Father.
Oh. Right. God, I'm very sorry.
Is the film any good, Father?
Well, what?
Is the film any good?
Well, I don't think you should be thinking about a film now that your wife has just died, Pat.
Sure, I'll go and have a look anyway, Father. I'll give you a ring about the funeral tomorrow.
Right. Oh, hello, John. Hello, Mary. It's lovely to see you. Thanks, yes.
And we're giving away free tickets in the shop this month. We hope it goes well for your fathers.
Great.
And Father McGuire, that colour really suits you.
Come on, well, Barry, we can go in and we'll watch the film. That colour looks good on you. Why are you
Oh, they're a lovely couple, John and Mary.
I've got Ted, yeah, they are. God, they're very happy, aren't they?
Ah, definitely.
Well, fathers, I must say, this is the most successful film we've had here since the Titanic. I've had calls from TV companies, production companies, the lot. It's going to put you on the map, fathers. I think it's getting more popular because of the whole protest. And Dougal has seen it the star in Dorset. Fantastic stuff, fathers.
Well, we didn't plan it that way.
Oh, would you look who it is? I haven't seen him move as fast since we had the Sharon Stone season on. This is massive. This is huge. We're going to blow the arse out of the Vatican with this one. Listen, I want you guys to play to LA next week. There's my car. Okay? Be in touch. This is terrific, guys. Hell of a job.
Dougal, we might need to get out of here.
Where are we going, Ted?
Well, back to the house. Morning, Dougal.
Morning, Ted. You big bollocks.
What did you say, Dougal?
I said, morning, Ted. You big bollocks.
Have you been reading them Roddy Doyle books again, Dougal?
Yeah, Ted. God, they're great.
Well, I suppose it's okay, Dougal. You know, if we do get a chance to go to LA, we might have the pleasure of Miss Clapp to write one of our novels. She's fantastic, Dougal. I'm a big fan.
All right, Ted. Well, I'm going upstairs to read my book.
Now, Father, did I hear you mention something there about Miss Clark?
Yes, Mrs. Doyle. I'm a big fan. She's fantastic.
God, I didn't think I'd hear you say that, Father, or even be a fan of those books. I tried to read a bit of one of them once. God, I couldn't finish it. The language, it was unbelievable.
Well, that's the modern world, Mrs. Doyle. It's a bit gritty.
Well, it was a bit much for me now, Father. Fet this and fet that.
Yes, Mrs. Doyle.
You big bastard, you big hairy arse. Fierce stuff. God, I don't know why they have to use such language like that.
Yes.
And the F word, Father. The bad F word. You know the one I'm talking about.
Yes, I know the one you mean, Mrs. Doyle.
F you. F your effing wife. I'll stick this effing pitchfork up your hole. That was another one, Father.
Right.
Bastard this and bastard that. You can't move with the amount of bastards in our novel. It's wall to wall with bastards.
Right, Mrs. Doyle.
Bastard, bollocks. Get your bollocks out of my face. That's another father there, that.
It might be best make some tea, Mrs. Doyle.
Right, Miss Doyle, this is another one then, Father.
God. Oh, oh no! I'm great, Noel.
I'm so excited. New Dougal in the film. It's fantastic.
Oh, the film, yes. It is very exciting, Noel.
You, Ted.
Yes.
Have a fucking dance.
Well.
Come on.
There's no need for a dance now. Right, okay.
Walk you up. As I told you, it was fantastic. Give the, all the cast a huge round of applause, please. And a special mention too for Brendan Keane here, co-director and in charge of sound. So if it's too loud for you, you know who's to blame. And show of appreciation too for the stage crew there. There's Sean Kenny, Pádraig Farrell, Niall Donohoe and Tom Gill who are making it all move very smoothly. As I said, the top prize in the raffle is that Mini Cooper car from Colin Quinn's. And I saw Tom Feeney going out to look at the car there before the show started. For those that don't know, Tom Feeney gave me driving lessons when I was very young. And it took me 7 times to get me driving test. So I hope, Tom, you didn't sit into that Mini Cooper. But as I say, buy the tickets for a great cause. They're going to make 2 contributions to 2 deserving charities at the end of the show as well. So, and all the other proceeds from the night will go towards the club. So we quick change round here and we'll be back to you in a few minutes and buy plenty of tickets. Thank you. Before we start then, one final shameless plug for Sean Mimna at the Shannonside Grill, who provided the halftime food inside. Voted best chips in Longford by the Longford leader, so they obviously are the best chips in Longford. So thanks very much, Sean Mimna. So as I told you, the show was meant to be in 4 parts, but Liam Connor and Sean Moran let you down, so the final part is a lot shorter. You're missing 1/4 of the whole show, so don't be anywhere disappointed, and don't take it out on them, or no recrimination. So enjoy the last 1/4 of the show.
God, Dougal, what a couple of days. The TV business, huh? Movies, people calling over to the house, even Father Noel coming over for a dance. He's great crack, Father Noel.
I know, Ted. Oh. It's great, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, Dougal.
We could get used to this. I think we should move to LA, Dougal, as soon as possible. Just go easy on that beer, Dougal. Oh, this could be Father Noel again, ready for more dancing. Or it could be Bishop Brennan. Hello, Father Ted Crilly speaking.
Crilly! Oh, wait till I get you and your crew, Crilly. This has been the most successful film since The Terminator 2. You better have your bags packed ready for my visit. It's moving parish for you, Ballymeague.
Thanks. God, Dougal, that was lame. Yes, we need to pack our bags, Dougal, for LA as fast as possible, Dougal.
All right, okay, then.
Oh, God, Dougal.
Now, Father Hacken, he had a lovely time on his walk. Went up to the cliffs now and it was a bit windy and he got a bit quiet all of a sudden, but sure, the brakes went then and that was it.
Great.
So now, he had a great time though. Now, Father Hackett.
God.
Up we go. Oopsie daisy, Father Hackett. Wakey-wakey now, come on now. Father Hackett. Man now, Father Hackett. Father Hackett. What about?
What's wrong with Father Jack, Mrs. Doyle?
He's very bad now after that walk, Father. I think he's after drinking a whole bottle of the Sleepy Nicey Snoozy Susie and the floor polish he got from Casterly's the other day.
Sure, we only got that in Casterly's last week. It couldn't be out of date.
He's very bad, Father. I think it could be serious.
I'd imagine we're over-exaggerating, Mrs. Doyle. A good cup of tea and he'd be absolutely fine again.
He has no heartbeat at all and no pulse.
Again, Mrs. Doyle, I'd imagine we're exaggerating.
My uncle's heart stopped for 4 days. And he was absolutely fine afterwards.
Really, Dougal, for 4 days, and he was absolutely fine afterwards.
Yeah, no, he was. I remember, he was... Oh, wait. Oh, no, no. Now that I think of it, he died.
Right. Well, look, I still think we're exaggerating, but I give Dr. Sinnott a call. Hello, Dr. Sinnott.
This is Dr. Sinnott's mobile number. Please leave your message after the beep. And it's, if it's the priest from the island, please fuck off.
It doesn't look like the doctor is in again. I might have to, I don't know, make a few other calls.
Father, would you mind saying the last rites there for Father Hackett, please?
All right. Okay. Well, we're gathered here today to celebrate the wedding of...
Father, it's the last rites for Father Hackett, please.
All right. Maybe you'd like to do it, Mrs. Doyle. I'll make the tea.
What?
No, of course not, no. I'm wearing the trousers as far as it dog goes. Well, Father, best of luck. No. Yeah, no, there's more. Well, you're up there now in heaven. I don't know, will I look up there? Will I look down here? I'll look up there, so. You're up there now in heaven with Bob Marley and Stalin and my parents. I'd like to take this opportunity to say hello to them. Hello, Mammy. Hello, Daddy. I hope they're taking care of you up there.
Excuse me, Father McGuire. It's the last rites for Father Hackett and they are in Latin.
Oh, yeah. Pepperoni, mozzarella, bechamel.
Come on now, Father Hackett, you settle yourself and go off to the morgue. We'll get you all dolled up now and dicky dude.
God, we might have a lot more things to get organised now for funeral. God. Oh. Dougal, would you make yourself useful there, Dougal?
You work right there, yeah, yeah.
Hello, Father Prilly. My name's Laura Corliss from Corliss, Corliss and Sweeney.
Oh, no, we're absolutely okay for Cole now.
No, Father, I'm not here about the Cole. I'm here about Father Hackett. I'm the local solicitor and I was just down the town.
Right, well, you better come in.
Well, you better sit down. I have a bit of a shock for you.
Listen, I assure you, that money was only resting in my account. It was a complete movement of funds from one bank account to another. It was completely legal.
No, Father, I'm here about Father Hackett. Just sit down and I'll explain everything to you.
Right.
Now, it may come to a surprise, but Father Hackett actually left a will.
Did he? What does it say?
If I may. I, Father Jack Hackett, being of sound mind and body.
Sorry, please, go on.
I, Father Jack Hackett, being of sound mind and body, give my entire fortune to Father Ted Crilly and to Father Dougal Maguire.
Fortune? Great.
For everyone, fathers!
Yes. That's great, Mrs. Doyle. Dougal, Father Jack left us £500,000, Dougal.
What? Oh. £500 each? Really, Ted? Oh, no. You got it all wrong, Ted. That's between us. That's only £250,000 each, Ted.
Anyway, fathers, it looks like you're going to be very rich men. Also, there's that sole requirement, and I'm surprised Father Hackett hadn't mentioned you before.
Yes, what was that?
Well, when's the funeral again?
Again? Well, no, I mean, we haven't had the first one yet. So.
It's tomorrow evening.
Okay. Well, you know Father Hackett had a terrible fear of being buried alive.
Well, no fear of that happening now, you know, because because he's dead.
Yes, he had an awful fear of that. He just didn't like enclosed spaces. He had an awful fear of confessions, and I guess he just didn't want to do confession.
Yeah, confessions. God, who'd be bothered with that, huh? In a dark room, alone, with strangers, telling you their sins.
Well, anyway, his fear was so great, he stipulated that both you and Father Ted stay with him the night before he's buried.
Right. Well, that's the least thing we can do. Anyway, we'll sort all that out with the solicitor.
I am the solicitor.
No, you're not.
I can assure you.
Like, just because we're from the island, you'd have a bit of fun with us.
I'm the senior partner of Corliss, Corliss and Sweeney.
All right, all right. The old tickles from the island. But we're not as thick as we look, eh, Dougal?
No way, Jose.
Now, wait a second. Why do you think I've called here and have been sitting here for the last half an hour trying to talk to you?
Listen, you're a lovely girl, but I really think we should sort all that out with the solicitor.
Oh, God! Well, Ted, if she's a solicitor, then I'm Daniel O'Donnell.
Oh, God.
Head.
Oh. True what they say about them career women, Dougal, they can be very aggressive.
She's very angry, wasn't she, Ted?
Especially when she hit me that time.
God.
And the language, Dougal, you wouldn't hear it from a doctor.
Ah, you wouldn't know, Ted. God, they use hard, bad language.
F this and F that.
Well, Ted, it was worse than that. She was saying fuck.
Now, Dougal! God.
Here's your luggage, Father, for when you're off to LA.
Thanks, Mrs. Doyle.
And I have some very bad news, Fathers. Bishop Brennan called earlier and he said he's on his way this evening. Do I need to tell her about Father Hackett?
Don't say anything, Mrs. Doyle, about Father Hackett. Just say we're going to a funeral and I guess make him stay the night and make him feel relaxed and hopefully we'll be gone by tomorrow to LA, just in time.
Right so, Fathers. Poor Father Hackett.
You know, God, Dougal, who would have thought Father Jack would have £500,000?
I know, Ted. I never said a word about it.
There it was, lying in the bank account all those years, Dougal.
How would he get there in the first place, Ted?
Well, from what I believe, he was an astute saver. He tried to avoid giving money to charity. He tried to avoid wearing trousers during the summer. That obviously saved a few bob in wear and tear. You know, so all sorts of little things, Dougal. You know, it all adds up. I guess we only really seen him in his twilight years, Dougal. A really lovely man. A true knight of the church. Gentle. Kind. Patient.
Who's this head?
Who do you think I'd be talking about, Dougal, at this particular moment in time?
I don't know. I didn't catch a stash.
Father Jack, of course. Jack!
Oh, yeah. Father Jack.
A great priest.
First priest to play with Recline Junior instead.
That's right, Dougal. And those were lively games with him as goalkeeper and referee all in the one.
You're right there, Ted.
And, you know, he loved children too, Dougal.
Really, Ted?
Well, they were a bit terrified of him, though.
Ah, yeah. Sure, I suppose, you know, he'd be going around with that stick, waving it in the air. They probably thought he was going to hit them or something.
Suppose so. I heard when he was up in Fermoyle, he was a great believer in discipline.
Really, Ted?
Yeah, I was chatting to Father Stone. He said that nobody had such effect on him as Father Jack.
Aye. And look how great he turned out to be, Ted.
Ah, that's right. You know, he also had a great sense of fair play about him, Dougal. And he didn't believe in a lot of modern thinking of the church. You know, and in the happy, no time I'll be sleeping, death took him. You know, someone once said that life is just but a thin sliver of light between two immensities of darkness. It makes you think, doesn't it, Dougal?
It does, Ted. About what?
About death, Dougal, about death!
Death? What start you off thinking about death? Ah, God, Ted, that's very morbid, isn't it?
Oh, God, Dougal. But you know, Dougal, maybe it's nice now that we can spend this time with him. And maybe we weren't as always as thoughtful as we could have been or should have been. So I guess it's nice now that we can spend this time with him and give him the respect he deserves to him.
You're right there, Ted. Do you fancy a game of charades?
Ah, that's a great idea, Dougal. Right. Mate, I have actually a great one for you, Dougal. Will I start?
Yeah, Ted, you go first.
Right, here we go now. Right. Let's go.
Oh, something to do with fishing. Gone fishing. No. Something to do with boxing. No. One-handed boxing.
Do it. It's a film, do it.
Ah, come on now, Ted. You're not supposed to tell me.
Right, here we go.
A film. One film.
One world film, Dougal.
Ah, come on now, Ted. You're making it a bit too easy, aren't you? I'm not an Egypt, you know.
Right, Dougal.
One word film. Can't be too many of them.
I'm great with you.
Home alone. No, teeth. Fins. Swimming in deep blue sea. On the back. Swimming teeth. Jaws 2. Oh, I was close there. Batman 2. Transformers 2. Home Alone 2.
It was Jaws 2, Dougal!
No, Ted. Jaws and Jaws 2 are completely different films. It's a completely different shark, Ted.
A different shark. Right, yes, Dougal. Okay, it might be best to get some sleep, Dougal.
I thought that.
Different shark.
Ted?
Yes, Dougal.
One question, Ted.
Look, Dougal, I said it before. When a woman and a man are in love...
No. No. Not that one, Ted. Do you believe in the afterlife?
Do I believe in the afterlife? Well, you know, Dougal, as priests, we tend to have a strong belief in the afterlife.
Oh, Ted, I wish I had your faith.
Dougal, how did you become a priest? Was it collect 12 crisp packets?
God! Ted?
Trying to sleep, Dougal.
Ted, I was just wondering, what are you going to do with your shared money? You know, apart from this whole LA crack.
Well, Dougal, you know, thankfully there are lots of charities that I'd like to donate to. Concern, St. Vincent de Paul, Casterly Shop, Claire Costello with the Hope Foundation. You know, so there's lots of things. So I guess, Dougal, some good will come from Father Jack's death.
Sad he's gone, though, Ted, isn't it?
Ah, you're right there, Dougal. It's beginning to snow again. Flakes, silver and dark, falling obliquely against the lamplight. It's probably snowing all over Lochree, on the central plain, on the treeless hills, falling softly upon the graveyards, upon the headstones of all the living and the dead.
Jack, my travelling bag, have you seen it anywhere? Mrs. Doyle, my travelling bag. Jack, have you seen my travelling bag? Are you awake?
I need to fucking see an
emperor. Oh, Father Hacker. You've made one big mistake. I'll be back here to move you to your new parish. You have not seen the last of me.
Is Jack dead or alive?
Well, I suppose the symptoms of no heartbeat and drinking the sleepy nighty snoozy snooze and floor polish brought about all the bad symptoms, Dougal. No heartbeat, as I said, you know, rigor mortis, decomposition. But I guess the effects just wore off him.
Good to have him back though, Ted, isn't it?
Yeah.
God, who needs £500,000 anyways?
Yes, I suppose, Dougal. But you know, and I don't like talking about it, Dougal, but it's only a matter of time. And you know, he's not a young man. So maybe when he does go, the money, it'll be of some comfort to us, Dougal.
Right there, Ted.
Now that reminds me, we do need to get down to shops and get some more of that floor polish and sleepy nighty snoozy snooze.
Perfect, Ted. Cassidy's or Spare?
I think we should try Cassidy's and Spare, and maybe for a bit of variety we might go across to Ballyleague as well.
Right, okay.
But you know, Dougal, we really need to stay out of the limelight. No more TV crews, no more film productions, and hopefully Len might actually stay away from us, you know.
What happened to him anyways, Ted? Mrs. Doyle was saying that Jack boxed him in the face in the morgue or something like that.
Oh, God, Dougal, please say it's not true. Oh, God, we're definitely moving Paris to Newtown Castle if it is true, Dougal. Oh, God, if only we had something to bargain with. Only just one thing, anything.
The money, Ted.
We can't use the money, Dougal. Oh, God.
Father's your new TV arrived this morning.
Oh, whoa! Well, great, Mrs. Doyle. I suppose at least something out of all this mess. Fantastic. Mrs. Doyle, what happened to Bishop Bremner?
He was raging, Father. He came into the morgue last night looking for his travel bag, and then Father Hackett boxed him in the face.
Oh, come on. Get this fucking thing now.
What have you got there, Father?
There's Len, Bishop Brennan. Where is he, Ted? He's on his holidays, isn't he? Who's that woman, Ted? Oh, God, what's he going to do? He's going to kiss her. Oh, he's kissing her, Ted. Oh, God, that's filth. Oh, that is disgusting, Ted. Oh, God, Ted, he's kissing her.
Oh. Something to bargain with, Len.
Hand that back.
How's it hanging now?
Get a hold of that.
How's it hanging now, Len?
Yeah, Len, how's it hanging now?
That might be the last we see of that gobshite, Dougal.
Dougal, it means now we can do anything we want.
Anything, Ted?
Yes, Dougal, get your guitar.
Oh, yes, rock stars, Ted!
Oh. Dougal, what was that song we were playing only last week? You know that song for Eurovision 1996?
My Lovely Horse, Ted.
Ah, yes, that's the one.
Right.
Ah, yes, here we go, Dougal.
Summer.